Hi, good morning. Let's go over the entire series of dead bugs, starting with the pelvic tilts to single leg to double leg toe taps, and then dead bugs in tabletop, and then let's challenge ourselves and finish with the straight leg dead bugs. And remember, throughout the entire exercise, the goal is to keep the hips and spine stable. Only the legs and arms are moving. And the goal of this exercise is to trunk integration, so integrating the movement of the legs and the arms, and also to strengthen the core, especially the lower core. And progress slowly, because the dead bug is a very fundamental exercise. It really helps to build a strong and stable body. So let's start out face up, and let's start with the pelvic tilts. So lie down on the mat, and then coming to a neutral alignment, so there's some space under the low back. Your sit bones are anchored evenly on the mat. The chest is open, the nose is pointing up. Press your heels, the ball of the feet, and your toes into the ground. And so let's start with the pelvic tilt. So we're going to press our low back into the ground, squishing the blueberry coming into an imprinted spine. And from there, we're just rolling back into a neutral alignment, keeping the knees also in line with the hips and shoulders. And from there, we're going to tilt the pelvis, the hips forward, coming into an anterior tilt, into a big mouse house. Legs are stable, upper body stable, only the hip is moving from a big mouse house into an imprinted spine. And then let's go back to neutral alignment and to an anterior tilt. Back to neutral and into a posterior tilt. Let's do one more. Neutral to anterior tilt and back to neutral. And so now let's progress into single leg tabletop. I'm going to start with my right leg. Hip stable, spine stable. Press your left heel, left ball of the foot, left toes into the ground. Also left butt into the ground, and bring your right knee into the chest. And then bring it back down without a change in the low back. And then let's lift it up again. And bring the leg back down. Let's do two more. The spine is unchanged, hips unchanged, only the right leg, the right femur, is folding into the chest. And four. Let's do the left leg. So right heel pressing, right foot pressing, right butt pressing. My hip is completely stable. It's not wobbling up and down. Bring the left leg, the left knee into the chest, and bring it back on the floor. Spine is unchanged, hip unchanged. And two more. You can also combine with the breath. Inhale as you bring the knee into your chest, and exhale as you bring the knee away from the chest. And then now let's do both legs. So hips stable, spine unchanged, space under the low back, and then lift both legs up and then bring it back on the floor. So now the stakes are a little bit higher. I feel it a lot more in my lower core. And also here I see my patients making the mistake that when they bring the leg back down, they moving their lower leg
so making the exercise a little bit easier, keep your lower leg at the same angle. So the femur, your thigh bone, is the one that's moving a lot harder. Just one more. There. Hug the knees into your chest. And then now let's go into the tabletop version of them. So create some space under the low back again. Neutral spine. Sit bones are anchored evenly. Chest is still open. Spine is still unchanged. Hip will be unchanged. Legs in tabletop. You can bring your arms out in front of you. Palms facing towards the feet. And then from here, drop the right leg down and then lift it back up. Let's do four. Spine is stable, hips stable. Only the right leg is moving. And three. And four. Let's switch to the left leg. Left leg down and lift it up. And two. And lift up. And three. Lift back up. And four. Last one. Now let's combine the movement of the arm with the leg. So right leg down, left arm back. Left leg down, right arm back. Core is stable. Spine is stable. Hip is stable. Trunk integration. And now let's go into both legs and both arms. So both arms come back and both legs go down. Pelvis is still unchanged. Spine is still unchanged. The legs are moving. If you want to combine with the breath, inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Two more. Inhale, exhale, and last one. Inhale and exhale. Hug the knees into the chest. And then let's do a straight leg. Only straighten, only lift your legs as high as you can, keep your knee straight. And also, if you can't keep a neutral alignment at 90 or at 80, then you can come into an imprinted spine. But there too, the goal would be the same. Don't let your tilt, don't let your pelvis tilt forward. Hip stable, spine stable. So straighten your legs as high as much as you can. Bring your legs as high as you can. Point your feet a couple of times, point and flex. And then let's bring the arms up. Point your feet. For first, you're going to drop your right leg down and lift it up. Left leg down and lift it up. I need to move that plant. Right leg down and lift up. Left leg down and lift up. And then let's combine the movement of the arms and legs. Right leg down, left arm back, and come back. And switch and lift it back up. Right arm and left leg. No, I said it wrong. Right arm and left leg. And bring it back. And two more. Right leg, left arm. Lift it up. Right arm, left leg. Lift it up. Hug the knees into the chest. And last one. Legs are straight. Point and flex a couple times. Spine is unchanged. The stakes are a lot higher. hip is unchanged, only the legs and arms are moving. Lower the legs and arms and lift them back up. And three more. Lower your arms and legs and lift it up. And two more. Lower down and lift up. And one more. And lift back up. Hard to speak like that. Hug the knees into the chest. And so play with these. Practice the level where you are and build a strong and stable body. And I'll see you back here soon. Hope this was useful and hope you are getting stronger. Have a good day.